you would immediately notice that there's a lot of similarity between the tournament algorithm and the sense reversing tree algorithm, and also similarity to the MCS algorithm. So let's talk about the difference between the tree barrier and the tournament barrier first. So the main difference is that in the tournament barrier, the spin locations are statically determined, whereas in the tree barrier, we saw that the spin locations are dynamically determined based on who arrives at a particular node in the tree in that algorithm. And what that means in the tournament barrier is that we can statically assign the spin location for the processes at every round of the tournament. And another important difference between the tournament barrier and the tree barrier is that there is no need for a fetch and fee operation. Because all that's happening at every level, at every round of the tournament, there is spinning happening. And what is spinning? Basically reading. And there is the signaling happening. What is this? This is just writing. So long as we have atomic read and write operation in the multiprocessor, that's all we need in order to implement the tournament barrier. Whereas, if you recall, in the tree barrier, we need a fetch and fee operation in order to atomically decrement the count variable. So that doesn't exist in the tournament barrier. That's another good news. Now, what about the total amount of communication that is needed? Well, it's exactly similar because of the tree arrangement. As you go up the tree, the amount of communication that happens is going to decrease because the tree is getting pruned as you go towards the root of the tree. And so the amount of communication in a tournament barrier in terms of order notation is exactly similar to the tree barrier. It is order log n. That's the amount of communication that is needed. Now, the other important thing that that I should mention is that at every round of the tournament, you can see that there's quite a bit of communication happening. In the first round, going up the tree, P1 is communicating with P0, P3 with P2, and so on. All of these red arrows are parallel communications that can potentially take advantage of any inherent parallelism that exists in the interconnection network. So that's good news, that all of this communication can happen in parallel if the interconnection network allows that kind of parallelism that can be exploited. And the other important point I want you to notice is that the tournament barrier works even if the processor is not a shared memory machine. Because all that we're showing here is a message communication. So P1, P0 is waiting for a message from P1, and so on. So all of these arrows, you can think of them as messages. And so even if the processor, the multiprocessor, is a cluster, by a cluster, what I mean is a set of processors in which the only way they can communicate with one another is through message passing. There is no shared memory, no physical shared memory. And even in that situation, the tournament barrier will work perfectly fine to implement the barrier algorithm. Now let's make a comparison of tournament to MCS. Now, because this tournament is arranged as a tournament, there are only two processes involved in this communication at any point of time in parallel. So it means that it cannot exploit the spatial locality that may be there in the caches. If you recall, one of the virtues of the MCS algorithm is that it could exploit spatial locality. And that is, multiple spin variables could be located in the same cache line. And the parent, for instance, could spin on a spin location to which multiple children are going to come and indicate that they are done. That's not possible in the tournament barrier because it is arranged as a tournament where there are two players playing against each other in every match. Similar to MCS, tournament barrier does not need a fetch and fee operation, so that's good, a common good property of both MCS and tournament. The other important thing where tournament has an edge over MCS is the fact that tournament barrier works even if the processors are in a cluster, meaning it's not a shared memory machine and it is only a cluster machine where only message passing is the way they can communicate with one another. Even in that situation, you can implement the tournament barrier. So that's another good thing. Now it's a good time for me to mention to you, I've been using the word cluster. What that means is that the set of nodes in the multiprocessor, they don't physically share memory, and the only way they can communicate with one another is through message passing. And it's important for you to know this particular terminology, cluster, because clusters have become the workhorses for data-intensive computing today, the data centers and the content distribution networks. We're going to see a lot of that when we talk about giant-scale services later on in this course. And those environments, they all use this kind of a computational cluster. And these computational clusters employ on the order of 1,000 or 10,000 nodes connected together through an interconnection network, and they can operate as a parallel machine with only message passing as the vehicle for communication among the processors.